So the sun is one of 100 billion stars in our galaxy alone. And it's the best studied of these stars, and probably it will always be the best understood and studied star. We observe the sun at all wavelengths of the electromagnetic spectrum, X-rays, radio waves, of course, the optical light that we see, ultraviolet light, infrared, and even gamma rays. The sun's atmosphere covers a remarkable range of temperatures, from about 6,000 degrees at the surface, which is the range of the atmosphere that produces the light we see. And I just want to say by surface, I don't mean a surface how we're used to on Earth, but the sun's surface actually is about 100 times less dense than the air around us. But it's so hot that it produces its own glow and radiation. So that's what we see, when you go outside every day. But as you go higher in the sun's atmosphere, the gas becomes a million times more dense, and it reaches incredible temperatures of millions of degrees. These different temperatures through the layers of the sun's atmosphere, they produce different amounts of light at each wavelength. And by measuring the amount of light at each wavelength, we form what's called a spectrum. And from this spectrum, we can measure the temperature at each layer in the atmosphere of the sun. And we can also measure how the temperature changes when interesting things happen in the sun. For example, when a solar flare occurs. In solar flares, the sun's radiation at all the wavelengths of light increase dramatically. This is the flare itself. Other stars also produce flares, and some of these other stars can produce flares that are 1,000 times more energetic than the flares on the sun. So they're pretty incredible. Some wavelengths of light that we just can't see during flares from other stars. These wavelengths are just too faint. So we rely on our knowledge of the sun to understand the temperatures and the processes that produce these wavelengths that we can't see from other stars.